I really don't think you have anything to worry about, Charlie Brown. After all, science has shown that a person's character isn't really established until he's at least 5 years old.
But I am 5. I'm more than 5.
Oh well, that's the way it goes.
I don't know what they mean. I want to
Lunchtime is among the worst times of the day for me. I don't sit here alone. Although, mornings aren't so pleasant either. Just lying awake, wondering if anybody would really ever miss me if I never got out of bed. Although, nighttime isn't so good either. Just lying awake, thinking about all the stupid things I've done and all the stupid things I've done in the hours in between. Lunchtime, it is one among the worst times of the day for me. Best I can just see what I got for lunch. Peanut butter. You know, some psychiatrists say that kids who eat peanut butter sandwiches are lonely. I guess I'm right. They're right. And we're extra lonely, the peanut butter is stuck in the roof of your mouth. Wow, PTA sure did a good job painting these benches. Hey, there's a cute little redhead girl. There's an empty seat next to her. I wonder what she'd do if I went over and asked if I could sit next to her. She'd probably laugh at my face. It's hard on a face when it gets laughed at. There's no reason why I shouldn't go over and sit next to her. All I have to do is stand up. Stand up. I'm standing up. I'm sitting down. I'm such a coward. I'm so much of a coward, she won't even think of looking at me. In fact, I can't even remember a single time when she has looked at me. Why shouldn't she look at me? Is she so great and I'm so small that she can't even spare one single moment? She's looking at me. She's looking at me.
No, Frida, you're thinking of the other dress, the one that I wore most of this party. I'm talking about the very light blue one with the sash embroidered around her waist and the big puppy sleeves.
I don't remember.
So I had a sash that went out like that. Well, I had a sash that went out like this, and then the bottom that went out like that. Puppy sleeves, just like that.
Oh, now I remember.
Yes, well, that was the dress I was wearing when I was talking to Violet, who told me that she'd see it just over.
Lunchtime is among the worst times of the day of the week. If the little redhead girl is looking at me with this stupid bag on my head, she must think I'm the biggest fool alive. But if she isn't looking at me, I can take it off and she'd never even notice that I did have this bag on my head. But on the other hand, I won't know if she is looking at me until I take the bag off. But I don't need to know if she's looking at me if I never take the bag off. And on the other hand, it is getting stuffy in here. Guess it's one more lunch hour over with. Only 2,863 to go.
Thank you.
discuss marriage with a musician.
Happiness is a fleeting thing, Sally. But I think a man can really achieve happiness if he directs the forces of his life towards a single goal that he believes in. And I don't think a man's personal search for happiness is really a selfish thing either. For if one man finds happiness, he can help another man find happiness too. Is any of this making sense to you, Sally?
Thank you.
I think I'll walk up to her and introduce myself. Yeah, that's it. I'll introduce myself. And I will ask if I can sit next to her. That will work. I'll ask if I can sit next to her. And I'll tell her how much I admire her. I think I'll just flap my arms and fly to the moon.
Yesterday, I was a dog. Today, I'm still a dog. Tomorrow, I'm probably a dog. There's just so little hope for a pants fit. Hey, Charlie Brown. Today is April Fool's Day. I think I'll play a little trick on you. I think I'll try a little trick. You do understand that today is April Fool's Day. I want to be certain you understand. You're sure? Okay. Hey, Charlie Brown! You see that little redhead girl over there? She told me that she wanted to give you a big hug and a kiss.
Really? That's fantastic!
April Fool's! Just like shooting a fish in a barrel.
Hey, Snoopy. Snoopy, do you see this stick? I, the human, will throw the stick, and you, the dog, will retrieve it. Got it? Ready?
I, the dog, could be less interested.
As a hobbyist and an adult. Many a man spends his day restoring antique automobiles, studying about the Civil War, or even building model train sets. This is called playing with the past.
Really?
Certainly. And it's important because it helps these men cope with their everyday problems. Now, I feel that it is imperative for me to get back my blanket. So I'm going to get it again! It's amazing what you can accomplish with a little smooth talking and fast action. Got you back again.
I'll try to outgrow it. It's my blanket.
Knowledge to me? Should you not share my seed? Perhaps
judge on the quality of co-hangers the drag king establishment uses to return my garments? Is that not the responsibility of my parents? Should they not share my seat? Thank you, Miss Altmar. Squeaky wheel gets the grease.
Little more rope, little more wind, little more wind. Gotta keep this movement in the fly. Gotta make sure it doesn't snag, doesn't droop, doesn't drag. Gotta watch out for every little less speed, little more pat, little less rise, little more slack. Gotta keep my legs without me now. Gotta make sure it doesn't get the best of me till I get in the air.
But if she
kissing me a Valentine? I gotta look. Hello? Nothing empty. Echoes more than an empty mailbox.
Hey, big brother. I've been thinking about why you haven't received any Valentines this year, and I think I figured it out.
What is it?
You didn't receive any Valentines because no one sent you any. Or happy like Snoopy, or lovely like...
Lucy. I'm beginning to feel a lot better already. You're a true friend, Lucy. A true friend.
That'll be 5 cents, please.
too commercial.
You know, when people are depressed, all they want to do is nothing. They want to leave their head on their arms, stare into nothing. But when they're really depressed, they want to change their arms.
Hey, Schroeder. What did you do with that picture of me I gave you?
I threw it away.
With your own hands?
Of course.
You touched my picture?
Hopefully, tomorrow will be a better day.
In some parts of the world, Charlie Brown, tomorrow's a brighter day. Today's yesterday. If tomorrow's today, Charlie Brown, there's no way tomorrow could be a better day.
Oh. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. 8, 3, go.
The name of the book about which this book report is about is the rabbit, which is about this rabbit. I found it very. I like the hardware. It was a. It reminded me of Robin. And the park where the little shows are coming from the chair, letting his back. And then Robin never once from the trees, a sudden surprise attack. It kept the sheriff and all of his goods.
In examining a work such as Peter Rabbit, one must not allow the reader to be blinded by the superficial characteristics of its deceptively simple plot. It must be urged to see the more substantial fabrics. In this report, I plan to discuss the sociological implications of family pressures so great as to drive an otherwise whole rabbit to perform acts of thievery which he consciously knew were against the law. I also hope to explore the personality of Mr. McGregor and his conflicting roles as farmer and humanitarian.
If I'm surviving now when I'm not really rested, it could upset my thinking, which is no good at all. I'll get a fresh start tomorrow, and it's not due till Wednesday, so I'll have all of Tuesday unless something should happen. Why does this always happen? I should be outside playing, getting fresh air and sunshine. I work best under pressure, and there'd be lots of pressure. If I wait till tomorrow, I should start writing now. But if I start writing now, when I'm not really rested, it could upset my thinking, which is no good at all.
From the story of Peter Rabbit, which this report is about.
you think. Oh yeah, that's what you think. Oh yeah, that's what you think. Oh yeah, that's what you think.
What?
It's my new philosophy. Oh yeah, that's what you think.
Why are you telling me?
What?
Why are you telling me?
Why are you telling me? I like it. That's a good philosophy. Why are you telling me? Why are you telling me?
Okay guys, the two things we have to remember are spirit and teamwork.
If you really remember,
that whole team was trash talking us, Charlie Brown. I got them back though. I said, oh yeah, you guys think you're so great? Beethoven was writing symphonies when he was your age. That really showed up.
I bet it did. Anyway, if we...
Charlie Brown. Okay, perhaps you shouldn't be a player manager, Charlie Brown. Perhaps you could be a bench manager.
Oh, that's a great idea! You could be a great bench manager, Big Brother! You could say, bench do this, or bench do that! You could even be in charge of where we put the bench once we get to field. You could say, let's put the bench here, or let's put the bench there!
I can't stand it!
What's the sense in our playing if we know we're gonna lose? I would understand there wasn't a million to one odds stacked against us.
Yeah!
There may not be a million to one, but there could be a billion to one!
Yeah!
Come on, everyone! Give me a T!
T! Yeah.
Dear pen pal, I could hold when you think this really fun. So would you please send directions on how I can get where you are? Your friend.
Thank you.
man I wanted to see. I'm conducting a survey, and I was wondering if you could answer a few questions for me.
Sure. Go ahead, Lucy.
Okay. So on a scale from 0 to 100, using the standard of 50 as average, 75 is above average, and 90 is exceptional, where would you rate me on regards to crabbiness?
You're my big sister.
That's not the question.
That's the answer.
That's the question.
Lucy, you and I, we both know. But if I give any sort of honest answer to that question, you're going to slug me.
Blindness. A survey that is not based on honest answers is like a house that is built on a foundation of sand. Would I be spending all my time if I didn't expect full candor in all my responses? I promise not to slug you. It's a woman's prerogative to change her mind. So now I just add up these two columns, and that gives me my answer. Schroeder was right. I'm a crabby person. I'm a very crabby person, and everyone knows it. I've been spreading crabbiness everywhere I go. I'm a super crab. It's a wonder anyone talks to me. It's a wonder I have any friends, or even associates. Where did I go wrong? How could I be so selfish?
What's the matter, Lucy?
Don't talk to me, Linus. I don't deserve to be spoken to. I'm no good.
Well, that's not true, Lucy.
Yes, it is. I'm no good, and there's no reason why I should go on living on the face of this earth.
Yes, there is.
Name one, just one good reason why I should go on living on this earth.
Well, one good reason is that you have a little brother who loves you.
Thank you.
skies are not cloudy all day.
Oh.
that as a star. It could be a planet, or even a satellite.
It could be a satellite. I wonder.
We'll never figure out just standing here.
Where are you going?
I'm gonna have a closer look.
I like to sit here after a supper time. This is the sound of the night. But something seems to be missing. Oh. In my opinion, that's exactly what we need.
That little redhead girl dropped her pencil. His teeth marks all over. She's human! Maybe today hasn't been such a bad day after all. Happiness is finding a pencil.
He's always saucy.
Telling the time. Happiness is learning to whistle.
Thank you. Alright, I hope you all enjoyed the play.
I know.
We all did. So we're going to wrap this up with a word of prayer. Dear God, I thank you for this play. I pray that everything we did brought glory to you, and that everybody enjoyed this play, and that we can all come out of here being a little bit more like Charlie Brown. In your memory, amen. I think Mr. Archie has a quick word for everybody.
Can we actually
emphasis on quick?
Can we actually bring the tech people up here? And then all the stage hands, stage manager, and then all the
to take them out of class in order for them to learn how to use a drill, learn how to paint, learn how to balance colors, learn how to make costumes, learn how to act and to sing and to dance. Real education takes place in these kind of things, and it takes a tremendous amount of effort from these young people. And Autumn is just an example of that. As a student director, she doesn't get any credit for this. This isn't some project for a classroom. She had her own project, she's a straight-A student, yet she's put hours and hours and hours into this beyond anything that she will get credit for other than the kind of hopeful lifetime memories that you guys have made with each other, with the ensemble that you guys have created. And it takes not just you guys, it takes you. It takes people like Mrs. Partridge, who works all day in the preschool and then comes over here and plays for us at night. It takes Deb Maston's years and years and years of experience and willing to work with kids and help kids and doesn't believe that there isn't a child that can't sing. It takes people like Dennis Norris, who has built every one of these flats that have 20 coats of paint on them. And they have been put up and down and up and down numerous times so kids can have a set that they can make and dream. It takes people like Pastor Paul, who comes in and takes that set and puts it together when we're all looking at each other and saying, how do we get it to stand up? It takes that in order to make something like this happen. So you're part of this. The fact that you came out when it was pouring down rain and you support these kids and that you guys are willing to work your tails off and playing basketball and running sound and playing softball and all the other things that you guys do, people don't know what it takes to do this. But you're here and I think you got a taste of it tonight. So thank you for coming. Thank you guys for being awesome. We love you very much. And I think you have something for someone, right? They have flowers for me.
Can we just express our appreciation to Mr. Hartley?
Thank you. made this joke last night that she constantly came to me and said, I've got a question. I said, that's a, and she would ask me, I said, that's a great question. And tonight she said, she wanted to do something. I said, well, you said I had to come up with the answer, so I'm doing it. So she's become that director that doesn't care what everyone else says. She just does what she wants. So good job. All right, great job. Thank you guys. Stick around, help clean us up. Don't leave till we're done. All right? All right, God bless everybody.
Hand it.
Hold on, we're going to get a picture of everybody.